In this video, I'm going to go through how to make a frequency table for these data here, which are students' heights in centimeters. Okay, so first thing I'm going to do, I don't have to do this, but I recommend it, is to go sort the heights first. Click on the top header here and then Control Shift down to highlight them all. Go to the Data tab, go to Sort. Check off that your data has headers and select the heights. Click OK. And now they're sorted. Next, I'm going to get the range for the data. So equals max. Click on the top data, Control Shift down. Close that bracket. That gives me my maximum value, which is 192 in this case. Same idea for the min, equals min. Click there, Control Shift down. Okay, and there's my min. Okay, next I need to figure out how many categories or classes I want to choose to split my data into. Now, there's a rough suggestion for the number of classes. It's the 2k rule, where 2 to the power of the number of classes that you choose should be slightly bigger than your number of data in the data set. In our case, we have 30 data, or 30 heights, so 5 classes is roughly ideal. Again, this is not a rigid rule though, but it's a suggestion. So I'm going to pick 5 classes. And now that I have that, I can calculate my width by taking my maximum value minus my minimum, which gives me my range, and dividing by my chosen number of classes. And that gives me 8.2. Now I could stick with that, but I like to pick numbers that are fairly friendly to work with, so 10 is close enough to 8.2 and a lot nicer to work with. Same idea for my starting point, or my first kind of lower limit, if you will. I could pick the 151. That's a little bit unclear, like a little bit messy though, so I'm just going to start with 150, which is close enough. And that's going to become my first lower limit. Okay, and now I'm going to go up by tens by taking that lower limit and adding my width to it. F4 to lock that width reference so that I can just pull this formula down. You just click in the little green box here and pull down. Those are all my lower limits. Okay, now for my upper limits, be a little bit careful here. I'm going to take my next lower limit and minus something from it. I'm going to minus 1. Now, why 1? Well, when I look here at the precision level of this data, it jumps up by 1s. Whatever my precision level is, subtract that off to get the upper limit. So take the lower limit for the next class and subtract the precision, which is 1. If these numbers were stored to the nearest decimal place, so 0.1, I would subtract 0.1 from here. If they were dollar amounts and they were stored to the nearest penny, I would subtract off 0.01. So just minus off either the 1, the 0.1, the 0.01 from your next lower limit to get the previous upper limit. I can pull that down all the way to here. Now let's try pulling it down too far. Notice that it just grabs an empty cell here. Okay, so several options. You can just look at the pattern here and see what's going on, or you can just take the previous upper limit and just add the width to it, which is 10. So notice that my lower limits jump up by 10s. My upper limits jump up by 10s. Those both match this width. Okay, Next, I need to get the number of data in this sum in each of these categories. I'm going to use a COUNTIF call for this. And I'm actually going to use two COUNTIFs. Okay, I'm first going to count how many data are less than or equal to the upper limit. And then I'm going to subtract off how many data are below the lower limit so that I just include all the data in this range. Okay, so let's have a look. Count if, grab the range. Now F4 to lock that. I always want to work with this range. And then comma, quotations, less than or equal to, end quotations. COUNTIF's a little bit weird how you have to put in this call. This means less than or equal to. You have to put quotes around it. And then an and then type the D10 where that upper limit is. I know it's hidden here behind my COUNTIF, but it's this D10. Okay, and that counts how many data in this range are less than or equal to this upper limit. Now I'm not quite done. I'm just gonna copy that COUNTIF call, and now minus from it, I'm gonna Control V, paste that, and just change it a little bit. Now I want to know or subtract off how many data are less than the lower limit, so that I don't count any data below the lower limit. Notice I just use a strictly less than, and now I'm grabbing the lower limit, but it's the same count if call other than that. Hit enter, and 10. And you can go double check here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 are all between 150 and 159, so that checks out. Okay, and since I've locked my ranges here, I can pull this formula down just like that. Just grab that little box, pull it down, and it will do the calculations for all of these limits here now. Notice I don't lock the references to the limits because I want to move down the table. Okay, so that's my frequencies. That's how many data are in each of these categories. I can also total those up, that should be 30. So let's double check. We just do an equal sum here and then highlight all those guys to total that up. And finally, to get our percent frequencies, I'm going to take each of these total or each of these frequencies and divide by the overall total number of data, which is 30. F4 to lock that 30 that we're referencing, and then pull that down. Now, if you don't see it marked as a percentage, what you're going to want to do, I'm just going to pull that all the way down to the 100, but yeah, click on this cell, or really click on all of them, highlight them all if you want to have them display as percentages, if they don't already. Go to home, and make sure it displays as a percentage. And then you can change how many decimals you see, just clicking here or here. Okay, and so this is my frequency table with my frequencies and my percent frequencies included in it. Thanks for watching.